Step 2. Creating the structural grid. In this step, we'll place a grid system with dimensions along with columns placed at the grid intersections. Open the 2.2 Creating Structural Grid folder in the Navigator view map. Activate the first Structural Grid preset view in this folder. Activate the Column tool. Activate the Column 1 favorite in the Favorites palette by double-clicking its name in the list. Activate the Dimension tool in the Document group of the toolbox. Then, activate the Linear Dim 1 favorite in the Favorites palette by double-clicking its name in the list. Finally, activate the Grid Element tool in the More group of the toolbox. Then, activate the Grid Element 1 favorite in the Favorites palette by double-clicking its name in the list. Please note, if there are numerous favorites in the project, first activate the tool of the element type you wish to use. Only favorites belonging to that element type will be displayed in the Favorites palette. This will help you to find the necessary favorite entry faster. Select the Design, Grid System menu item to open the Grid System Settings dialog. A grid system is a collection of elements, including grid elements, columns, beams, and dimensions. Grid elements are always placed, while other element types can be placed optionally. In the General Settings panel of the dialog, you can set whether the grid will be orthogonal or radial. Further, you can select which element types should be generated along with the grid elements. Check the Elements at Gridline Intersections checkbox. In the drop-down list to its right, select Column. This will place columns at each gridline intersection point when a grid system is placed. Click the Settings button to the right of the drop-down list you just set. This opens the Column Settings dialog. The settings you now see in the Column Settings dialog are the ones that were set by applying the Column 1 favorite. This is why we applied column and linear dimensioning favorites in earlier steps. They will be created with those settings when the grid system is placed. Click OK to leave the dialog. Check the Dimension Lines checkbox. Enter 1000 into its value field. Also, check the Total Dimension checkbox. Enter 500 into its value field. This will cause dimensions and total dimensions to be generated for the grid elements and will set their distances from the end of grid elements. You can specify the settings for the individual grid elements in the Grid Elements panel. Click the Grid Elements Settings button to go to the Grid Elements Settings dialog. Grid elements have their own settings, including Show on Story, Gridline Type, and Pen, both on the floor plan and in sections and elevations. Naming rules for the axes, as well as for the markers, can be customized. Markers can be placed at either or both ends of the grid elements, and so on. Click Cancel to return to the Grid System Settings dialog. The Naming Rules panel lets you specify the identifier names for grid elements to be generated. They can be set to be generated automatically, for instance, letters starting from A for horizontal grid elements and numbers starting from 1 for vertical grid elements. In the Grid Positions panel, you can set the spacing for both horizontal and vertical grid lines. In the Horizontal Grid Lines field, enter 7,500 in the Distance field for grid line B. Click the plus sign above the Horizontal Grid Line list twice to add two new horizontal grid lines. The distances automatically assigned to these grid lines are the same as the distance of the grid line preceding them. Modify the distance value for gridline C to 9,000. Now, in the Vertical Gridlines field, enter 7,500 in the Distance field for gridline 2. Click on the plus sign above the vertical gridline list successively until you'll have 19 gridlines set. Scroll down and then modify the distance value for gridline 9 to 5,200. We've now set everything needed before placement. Click OK to close the dialog. Place the grid system by clicking on the point shown by label 1.1. Then, by clicking again on the point shown by label 1.2. The first click defines the position of the first gridline intersection. The first and second clicks together define the horizontal direction of the grid system. An information pop-up appears stating, as the result of the last operation, elements have been created and or changed their position on currently unseen stories. This is because the grid system and its components are created on all stories. We can ignore this message in this case. Click Continue to have the grid system generated. As you can see, not only grid elements, but also columns and dimensions were created. Activate the next preset view from the Navigator view map. This will present the entire structural grid we have just created. Click on any grid line on the floor plan and notice that all other grid lines are also selected. This is because of a feature called Auto Group. When several elements of the same element type are created in one step, the Auto Group feature causes a new group to be created automatically and these elements to be added to it. Click anywhere on the floor plan to deselect the grid lines. Groups are useful when you want to move related elements together. Activate the Edit, Grouping, Suspend Groups option to suspend groups and to edit elements individually. Click on any grid line on the floor plan and notice that none of the other grid lines are selected now. You can also suspend element groups using the Suspend Groups toggle in the standard toolbar. We will use the Suspend Group command because we need to modify the location of grid lines. Click anywhere in the floor plan to deselect grid lines if they're still selected. Make sure that the guidelines and tracker buttons are activated in the standard toolbar, and activate the arrow tool from the toolbox before proceeding. Select the horizontal grid lines. Draw a selection rectangle by clicking near label 1.1 and label 1.2 to define the diagonal of the selection rectangle. Please do not click at the point of the label because that will select the labels instead of drawing a selection rectangle. Right-click on an empty area of the floor plan to activate the context menu. Select the Move, Drag menu command from the context menu. Click anywhere to define the starting point of the drag vector. After you've clicked, a little info box called Tracker appears to the right of your cursor. The tracker shows the distance and angle of the cursor for your first entered point. With its help, you can accurately input numerical values. Move the cursor horizontally to the right. You can use the guidelines to find the appropriate direction. The tracker should display 0 degrees in the angle field. Enter 5,000 on the keyboard, and then press Enter. Then, click elsewhere to deselect the currently selected elements. Select the vertical grid lines with the arrow tool by drawing a selection rectangle. Click close to label 2.1 and label 2.2 to define the diagonal of the selection rectangle. Select the Edit, Move, Drag menu command, or activate it from the context menu. Click anywhere to define the starting point of the drag vector. Move your cursor vertically upward. The tracker should display 0 or 90 degrees in the angle field. Enter 5,000 on the keyboard, then press Enter. Click elsewhere to deselect the currently selected elements. The grid lines are now at their correct positions. Switch to the project map in the Navigator. Open the Stories folder and double-click the names of each story to activate them. The placed columns extend only from the bottom of the ground floor to the top of the second floor. Thus, they are visible only on these stories. Check that the previously created elements are present on every story. Right-click on an empty area of the floor plan, and in the Appearing Context menu, select Show All in 3D to go to the 3D window and see what we have so far. The 3D window shows the masses created in the first step and the columns that were created during the placement of the grid system. As you can see, these are multi-story columns extending several stories. These were set to be shown on all stories they cross. Select any of the columns in the 3D window. Right-click the column and select Column Selection Settings from the Appearing Context menu. Find the Show on Stories settings under Floor Plan Display in the Floor Plan and Section panel of the dialog. This setting is set to All Relevant Stories. This results in these columns being shown in all stories from ground floor up to the top of the second floor, because based on the bottom elevation and height of the column, these are the stories it crosses. Click Cancel to leave the dialog. To return to the floor plan, click elsewhere to deselect the column. Right-click on an empty area of the 3D window, and in the Appearing Context menu, select Go to Floor Plan.